evaluate as a chance time or yeah, where I was yeah about that. I know talking about JP Gainojin, that means celebrate gear in a JP language. So today you learned some of the other language too as an inspiration. Gay means like talent in the JP language, and no means like ability in the kanji that they write. And jin means people, a person. So it means celebrity. One of the direct translation is. So, but talking about so many people also introduced me, some of the Asian people or JP people, but JP people before, but yeah, so I tell, if it's JP people, I am a big fan of the, if I'm in a JP like Domo to Koichi, or SMAP, those Katori Shingo, or Takezawa Hideaki, or Shibuya 109's Girl Style around 2010, those like Egg Magazine or with Nemo Yamo, those are my cliques, my types. We inside JP, if I'm in the JP, we don't talk to the other group of the people very much and not really interested in. It's kind of like wasting a time. But so inside JP, those are especially like Domo to Koichi, that's like, yeah. Okay, but those are just celebrities, so it's different. Yeah. And somewhere a long time ago, so yeah. Right, and when I was around 10 years old or 11 years old, it's the other side of the story, but yeah, I had feelings and I had a huge crush. I was like around 11 or 12 years old to my classmate. Or if I had my old best friends, the other best friends, it would be very much easier. And probably she knows this. I could talk about him to her, but yeah. And I had a huge crush to one of my classmates. And I knew him for a few years, every single day. And all my classmates, all my girls in my class, they knew him too. So, kind of we approved him as a wonderful person, as a wonderful personality, a good character. So, I fall in love with him. He probably like this other name, Jenna. Nickname Jenna, yeah, probably he liked Jenna. Or Rachel. He liked her, probably, because he probably liked one of our classmates. But she was one of the prettiest, probably. So he liked her. When I saw him, I could kind of notice. But yeah, that was kind of depressing to me. But yeah, I was also thinking about becoming a nun, where I had a calling, or where I, yeah, when I was a child, my dream was to become a nun. Some part of my dreams were, or maybe so. I never thought about like, making out with him or anything when I was 12 or 13. Maybe because I was thinking about becoming a nun, so that's why. Yeah, but I had a huge crush on this boy, my classmate. He was maybe 5 months older, no, 5 months younger than me. Same year, almost at the same time I was in love. I was in love with this boy next door, a man who lived next door, and secretly I wrote on a wood heart. It was my handmade wood, and the shape of that wood is a heart. And one side I wrote my name, and the other side of it I wrote his name, a nickname like Dan. I wrote his name Dan, and I wrote my name. Example of my name, a childhood nickname, if that time was Sarah, like I wrote that name, my name and his name on the backside. So I thought we're gonna marry in the future, maybe. I mean, yeah, even I was thinking about some of the different future, a different dream or different things in the future. But helplessly, I dreamed about marrying him. When I was around 11 years old, or maybe 10 years old. I don't remember exact time, but yeah. So if I have that stuff, if I have that, my handmade that stuff, and I hide it inside my, in the desk, some of the I hide it inside my study desk. And if I have that, my dream come true, and probably he's gonna be fall in love with me, and we can marry in the future. We can marry in the future. That's what I dreamed about. Yeah, well, that's some other a little love story of a long time ago. Oh, and let's do some of the creative book clubs too. A book club here. So, this Tyler, there are so many people that I know the same name, Tyler or Taylor too. Yeah, oh, there are so many good Taylors too. Every Taylor, I love you. I think you are all so, yeah, you're all amazing. Fantastic people. Yeah. So, in your book club, Taylor and Tyler was working in some of the graveyard. Well, it's a good graveyard. Their grandparents, one of their ancestors were buried in that graveyard. So they were walking. They were walking on the street. They were walking in that big graveyard area. It's a famous and very protected. There are security people, security guard too. It's a gated graveyard area. So, when those two, Tyre and Taylor, were walking by to greet their ancestors, and to greet one of their great, very great, great ones, ancestors there. It was like a sightseeing. It was like a tour. And one time, they heard some sound. The bird dropped a magic book right in front of their path. A magic book. Well, oh no, but Tyler have a secret scent, so he knew instantly that's a magic book.